8 steps to securing your router. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com, where I try and give you a little bit more confidence and allay some of the fear that we have with respect to technology every day. So, your router is a surprisingly important and, in some cases, undervalued piece of equipment. It shares your internet connection. It's what allows you to connect multiple devices to a single internet connection. But it does so much more, particularly when it comes to security, the security of all those devices you have connected through it. Here are 8 things that I want you to do to make sure your router is as secure as it possibly can be. Number 1, change the administrative password. Many routers used to come with the same administrator password, which is really not particularly secure. Nowadays, they tend to come with something that's been at least unique to that device, but it's still on a sticker on the box somewhere. When in doubt, change the administrative password to something that you know that is not on a sticker. And certainly, if you've got one of those devices that all come with the same default password, change it right away. Hackers do know how to use that. In that same vein, disable remote management. Most of the time, when we are managing our router, we're doing it from one of our machines that are connected to it. Many routers, in fact, I'll say most routers, actually allow for management from the internet side. This can be useful if you're traveling or if you're trying to manage somebody else's router on their behalf. But if you don't need it, turn it off, because it is just another way that hackers can also try to break in and wreak havoc with the router configuration. Speaking of configuration, turn off UPnP, Universal Plug and Play. It was intended as a way for programs running on your machine to more easily change router configurations to do whatever it is that program needed to do. Guess what? Malware felt the same way, and it decided, you know what? If I can use UPnP to configure the router to do what I needed to do maliciously, I'll do that too. So turn that feature off. When you're using Wi-Fi, technically Wi-Fi is a separate box. It's an access point, but in most cases these days, Wi-Fi is actually in the same box as your router. Make sure to use WPA2 or WPA3 for your Wi-Fi connection. That means don't have an open Wi-Fi hotspot, because anybody within range could connect. WPA2 and WPA3 secure the connection so that only those people who know the password can connect. WEP, which shouldn't be available anymore, is not sufficient by any stretch. If WPA is the only thing that's available, use it, but realize that it too is not as secure as you want it to be. WPA2 and WPA3 are the things to use. Disable WPS, Wi-Fi protected setup. It's not protected. There are several ways an attacker can use WPS to essentially attach themselves to your network, even if you have a Wi-Fi password set. Turn off logging. This is more of a convenience and a performance issue, but you may not necessarily want what you're doing to be viewable to someone who comes along later. Turning off logging does that. Now, most consumer routers don't necessarily have logging saved on the router themselves. They can sometimes be configured to essentially send the log of information to what they're doing to a different device elsewhere on the network. Regardless, unless you have a specific need for logging, make sure it's turned off. Secure your router physically. This is one that a lot of people overlook. Remember, anybody that can walk up to your router and hold down the reset button for 3 seconds can reset your router to its factory settings. Then they know the master password, they know the administrative password, they know how to get in, and they can start playing games with your router configuration. If that's at all of concern to you, if you're in a shared space, if you've got people around that you may not necessarily trust, make sure that the router is locked in a closet or locked in a room or otherwise physically protected. And finally, number 8, Check for firmware updates. These are one of those things where we don't necessarily get notifications. Unlike with Windows and the applications that we use, we're often presented with information that, hey, there's an update available, or in the case of Windows, updates just happen. When it comes to routers, that's rarely the case. What that means for you is that you simply need to periodically sign in to your router's administrative interface and check for updates. I hope that's helpful. All of that should lead you to a much more secure router and a safer online experience. For comments, for updates, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/11107. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.